And rhythm guitar, John Wilkerson.
The story of John Wilkinson's friendship with Elvis Presley goes back a long way. The two first met when John was only 10 years old, and Elvis came to play a show in his hometown of Springfield, Missouri.
And I'd seen clips on our one and only TV station at the time of Elvis on the old Louisiana Hayride. And I thought at the time, he looks like he's having an awful lot of fun. I'll bet he's getting paid to do it too. But he was beaten on this beautiful Martin D18 guitar. It kind of hurt my feelings. You have to understand, I started playing guitar when I was 5 years old and three-finger bluegrass banjo when I was six.
John promised himself he'd give Elvis a lesson or two, and he got the opportunity to do so when he snuck backstage and into Elvis's dressing room.
When I finished, I put the guitar back up against the wall and I sat down and he said, "You're pretty good." And I said, "I know." And I started to walk out the door and he said, "Johnny, come back here a minute." I said, "Okay." And he shook my hand and gave me a big hug. And in a very soft voice, he said, "Johnny, I just know deep down my heart we're going to meet again."
They did meet again. And when Elvis formed his TCB Band in 1968, he handpicked John to play rhythm guitar, leading to several successful tours together.
We all knew each other. We were like family. The Sweets and the Imperials at the first, and then J.D. Sumner and the Stamps. We were all like family. And that's what Elvis was hoping for.
On stage, John says Elvis was electric. Audience members couldn't take their eyes off of him. Off stage, Elvis was a ton of fun, a total practical joker.
And that laugh was so infectious that you couldn't help but feel good and laugh right along with him when he was. He was a funny man. He had a wonderful sense of humor.
To this day, John often thinks of his good friend Elvis, still wearing his TCB emblem, and wearing it proud.
That's been on my neck every day since July 31st, 1969, when Elvis personally put it around my neck. Besides my own father, he was probably the most kind and compassionate and considerate and generous man I've ever met in my life.
Jackie Jones for Elvis.com.